Hi, I'm Thomas with RF Elements, and I will walk you through the new features of our updated version of Link Calculator we now call Link Calculator 2.0. Let's start with the single CPE calculator. A few changes have been made to the AP settings. You can select any of our antennas as before, plus we also added the sector carrier class 520, since many of our customers still use this antenna. Now you have an option to select a channel width, which helps to get a more accurate estimate of the link performance. When choosing a channel width, you might notice that for some of the options, you will get a warning sign in the CPE settings and no results will be shown. This is because that particular CPE does not support the channel width you've chosen. So when choosing a channel width, you must know which ones your CPE supports. On the right side, there is now the CPE settings and results section. The drop-down menu lets you choose from the most popular CPEs of major manufacturers. If you didn't find the CPE you were looking for in the list, you can either select the generic 802.11ac or 802.11n radio. Some of the CPEs have an integrated antenna. In this case, the gain field is not editable. If the CPE does not have an integrated antenna such as this one, you can edit the gain according to what antenna you use. The results of the calculation are now highlighted. The received power and MCS rate the link can work at are shown directly below the CPE settings. The MCS numbering follows the 802.11ax standard. Another change is visible in the received power graph. While the y-axis of the graph is still received power, the color legend tells you what MCS you can achieve at what distance. The link details tell you the maximum range at the MCS you're currently at, and the other details remain unchanged. The multi-CPE calculator has a few more upgrades. Besides being highlighted under the CPE settings, the received power and the MCS results are now shown also directly in the map for quick reference. A major change is that now you can see the coverage zones on the map, which makes the planning a lot easier because now you immediately see what MCS rate you have in which area. While the highest MCS rates are usually the most desired ones, by clicking on the numbers on the MCS scale, you can turn on the lower MCS zones if you want to, as well as turn off any MCS zone depending on what you're interested in. When you change a parameter in the settings or the heading of an antenna, the coverage will be recalculated, which takes a few seconds, and it is indicated by the pulsating blue area corresponding to the antenna beamwidth at -6 dB. There is an additional way to add new CPEs by using the button directly on the map. One thing to be aware of is that the coverage shown is always specific to the CPE currently selected. It says at the bottom of the map for which CPE is the coverage valid. In this example, the CPE 2, 3, and 4 are of the same type and settings. This is why there is no difference between the expected coverages. CPE 1 is a different type of device, so by selecting it, the coverage has to be recalculated and in the end looks differently compared to the rest of the CPEs. You can also use the full screen mode for better user experience. The whole control and results panel are included there, so you can edit the parameters of your links directly in the full screen mode. If you're completely new to the calculator, make sure to check the videos on the bottom of this page for full instructions. We hope you find these upgrades useful and we're looking forward to your feedback, so please let us know if you discover any errors or if you're missing any features. Thank you.